Sean. I forget what I was going to say.
This week in the news.
Love Island.
Love Island 2019, everybody. Very relevant topic, very trending. We thought we'd go through everything that's happened in Love Island this week. We got a quick update call from our good friend, our Love Island expert.
A connoisseur of Love Island.
Mr. Aaron Dempsey.
Yolande and Arabella don't like each other, obviously, because they're fighting over Danny.
Of course.
Did you see the state of that sandwich Tommy made?
He made a sambo.
Yeah, just here.
Baked beans and apple sauce or something. We need something chill about that.
Look at that. It's literally...
That's an abomination. What the fuck is that, man? Oh my god. That's why he's so big. That's all him and Tyson if you only eat at home. It's just sambos with red sauce and mayonnaise. At 2 o'clock I had bread with ketchup. At 4 o'clock I had bread.
Mayonnaise.
Sometimes I like to spice them with ketchup too.
Elmer and Anton, I'll come to you first.
Oh, so I think what happened, right, okay, is this recording?
Yeah.
Right, okay. I think what happened, right, the two least compatible couples were put together and then the public voted off too. Lucy.
Oh, no.
Joe!
He was, I thought though, remember you were saying about odds. Joe was like predicted to win, like the whole thing.
Yeah, but he got.
Yeah, he got kicked off. He's like one of the first people to get kicked off.
Elmer got kicked off as well. That's what it was. Elmer got kicked off along with Joe. So Anton's pre-game and they brought in a new young one, Arabella. Can we just point out Curtis's reaction to when Arabella came off the oak? Pull up there, pull up Curtis. So look up Arabella comes into Love Island.
Right.
He's going out to get his coffee or something. Right. But watch this, like something out of Baywatch. Watch this. Watch where he goes.
Holy.
Hello.
Oh, good morning.
He's actually a nice bloke. He's.
Yeah, he seems pretty
alright. He's the only, like, decent...
Yeah, yeah.
He's only like, oh, you're well fit, innit?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He seems like...
Yeah, he's like, he's the barroom dancer, though, isn't it? Like, that's what he does, like...
Good dancer, tiny penis.
He's saying it wrong because his mom's beside him. He knows quite well what the name is.
Yeah, that's a good point.
You know, Ara, John, Ara. he knows quite well what the name is. Like.
Basically, after Arabella entered the villa,
she got a text saying she had to go on two dates with two different blokes. Don't know who the other bloke is, but I just know that one of them was Danny, who is Yolanda's couple, whatever.
To be honest, when you said you want to take me on a date, my gut feeling was really excited. Like, just how much I'm enjoying this date means I've got a... problem.
So basically after Arabella and Yolande clashed, they had a very passive aggressive argument.
Arabella plays it all cool and
Yolande
kind of snaps a little bit.
You know, like earlier when I was chatting on the beanbag with him and Anton and then you came over and you literally just like sat on him, which I have no problem with like you coming over to having a chat, but I just feel like it's a little bit like territorial.
Not really.
hold on. Wait, the closest thing you can do next to sitting on someone, lifting up their leg and fucking pissing on them. You know what I mean? Like, that's what she might as well have just done that. Like,
after Danny and Arabella went on the date,
so one day lays a tick with Danny.
Yeah. If I see you looking at Arabella, within 60 seconds,
okay. In his head, there's just a monkey with the cymbals, like he's not listening. He's just... Right, so they had the kissing challenge. Anyways, they had the kissing challenge.
To recreate my normal kissing conditions, the boys are blindfolded and wear noise-cancelling headphones, although unlike me, they don't have a safe word. The girls make their way down the line, kissing each boy who marks it out of 10.
Didn't faze me going first, like,
No problem to me.
I'm Maura Higgins. And you know what? Like, I tell you, you wouldn't know what that man is thinking.
No, you fucking wouldn't, mate.
With Tommy.
I really enjoyed it.
I would give it an 8 out of 10 strong kiss. It's very wet and voluptuous.
That's the biggest word he's used.
After making that sample, his brain is fried. Curtis made a balls of it, and Danny gave it socks with Arabella. That's what happened.
Yeah.
We're so good at this. We're like connoisseurs. We're deadly. We're so good. Definitely didn't watch 2 minutes of the video, just to try and recap.
It was a little bit fast, but I'm going to go 7.
Literally, that boy, like, I thought he could never do any wrong in my eyes, and today he's shown me that he can be, like all other men, an absolute tool.
Amy was also very pissed off. Very sad time for Amy, as she is also fuming with Curtis.
Fuming is a reoccurring theme in this show.
Good connection as a 10.
Oh shit.
There was Curtis giving supermodel Arabella 10 because it was a great connection.
Okay, she gave Arabella a 10, bro.
I know.
Yeah. Funny, isn't it? Yeah.
She was definitely one of them kids when she was younger. Like, you know, like if she was a bloke, if she owned the football and it didn't go the way she wanted, she'd go home. I mean, you know, you know what I mean? Like, you're all the Astro, you're all playing ball. Nah, fuck this, I'm going home. You know what I mean?
The fact that they're all laughing at me, like, I don't really like that, but I'll talk to you about it later.
Can I
scratched your neck, so you knew it was me, and then you gave me a 7, and then you rated everyone else really high as well.
Didn't know that was used from a scratch of the neck.
I gave you the signal. I gave you the signal.
Morse code.
She was kissing him, she was whispering Morse code in his ear beforehand.
So basically what happened was, after Ioande and Arabella and all them had that big beef, Moira got a text to say that she was going to be able to go to the hideout. After she won the challenge. And she's going to bring Tom and,
have a look and see what happens.
Maura, as the winner of today's challenge, you may now invite a boy of your choice to spend the night with you in the hideaway. Happy
bunny. What is she screaming for, man?
Do not disturb.
Do not disturb.
I got a text.
Would you mind her narrating your life or something?
Go to the bathroom and brush your teeth. Basically, Tom kind of fucked it a bit. He's talking with the boys and
he said
she's all mouth or something.
Yeah, just let's see if she's all mouth.
Yeah, I'm not overthinking it. Yeah, but it'll be interesting to see if she is all mouth or not.
What did you just say to them?
No, why?
What did you just say?
Just then. It'll be interesting to see if you're all mouth or not.
Are you fucking joking?
Why?
That's a dickhead comment.
What?
Fuck off.
You know what the worst part about that is? Is that he literally says it while she's there. She's standing there and he says it.
And then he repeats it to her. She asks him, what did you say? And he's like, just asking if you're all out of mouth or not. Yeah, no, that's pretty much it for this week, people. I hope you enjoyed the video. Smash like. It was a fun one to do.
It was. I'm glad to be back. You know that? I'm glad to be back. Yeah,
make sure to subscribe. Make sure to subscribe. That would mean the most to me. And the Instagram, and Jack's Instagram, all the other grams, and all the other plugs.
Everything.
Just do it all, okay?
Every single bit of it.
That's pretty much it, people. I'm out for this week. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Woo.